Hi, my name is Swati. The name of today's blog is Kids and Their Spaces. So when I was writing this blog, it was more about just learning about the physical space and mind space. And I was just thinking through that how we are not able to see the mind space. We can see the physical space, but it is so important to also get to know your mind space. That's when I wrote down some of the thoughts. Please let me know what you're thinking. Take a listen to it, and I will connect with you again in my next blog. Thank you for listening. Kids and their space. Space. We all like our space, especially as an adult. One of our spaces is the physical space that we live in, and the other is the space in our mind. Do we all like our space? Now, is that even a question? Of course we do. I especially like my space when I can think for myself, be who I like to be, organize my thoughts, and start implementing them as and when I want to in both spaces. Now, when we were kids, did we get to enjoy our spaces, the physical and the mental space? I think sometimes we did, sometimes we did not, but times were a little different. I feel there was more adjustment and more learning to live together and enjoy both spaces. Let's think about the experience that we had when we could not. Was it really the physical space, or it was more of the mind space? When I was growing up, coming from a joint family, we all had our spaces, but the focus was more on the grooming of mental space and not just the physical space. Understanding one another, learning to cherish the relationships, helping each other, showing care and concern, respecting each other, most importantly, appreciating and participating in both spaces. The spaces surely seemed enough. We learned how to work around in the physical space and learned how to create even more open mind space. Participation and involvement in the family activities helped me to grow in each space. The question I was thinking was, are the kids getting enough space of their own? Frankly, I think we are giving our kids the physical space, at the same time filling it all up with so many material things that today's kids are being constantly pushed away from their mind space. It is kind of like we provide the answers to questions that do not even exist in their mind. And then we keep expecting, how come there isn't much of a curiosity to find out or ask about? Let us think of some ways to find out how we all can help one another to realize that the mind space is the one that we need to hold on to more by inviting each other into that space. With a huge mind space, not just one's own, but together, we will be able to enhance our everyday experiences in a true sense. Physical space gives more of outside ownership, but mental space will definitely give inside ownership, which will stay with one forever. What do you think? Please share your ideas. Thank you.